Alright, it's Tough Free Tuesday time again. Last time there wasn't one, but this time there is. So, and this was at times by some I've never heard of before, GameStorm. I have no idea. But anyway, it's Tough Free horror themed video games. Obviously ties in with tomorrow Halloween, which is a good thing. Makes sense. Because there's no such thing as Tough Free Wednesday. But anyway. So yeah, here's mine. I guess this is the closest order I would actually put these three. Number three would be Resident Evil. That is the first Resident Evil back when the things actually used to be survival horror. I can tell you right now, video games don't scare me. I've already talked about this before. But that doesn't change the fact that they're horror themed, you know. So the very first Resident Evil was not the first survival horror game. Technically, that doesn't even go to Alone in the Dark. It goes back to things even further back than that. But anyway. Actually, Haunted House in the Atari 2600 is usually considered the first survival horror game. But anyway, Resident Evil is technically the actual first... No, I actually did play Alone in the Dark before that, but whatever. Resident Evil is the first one I actually played on the console. There we go. I fixed that. Played Alone in the Dark on the computer. I like Resident Evil more, but whatever. First Resident Evil is very dark, foreboding. You're isolated. Not at first, but eventually you are. You're cut off from the rest. Wesker disappears, then, you know, you choose which character you want to be, and then you're just by yourself through the mansion against all kinds of freaky things, normal T-virus zombies, crimson heads, all kinds of crazy shit, and then it just escalates from there, and eventually the mansion blows up. It's just the way it goes. Number two would have to be probably Ghouls and Ghosts. That is, I'm going by the one I have on the Genesis Mega Drive. It's just correct theme for it, or I guess you could also put Demon's Crest in here, since I actually do like that game more. One of the games I need to get again off my list. But anyway, it's all different kind of things. You have ghosts, as the title says, ghosts, goblins, ghouls, monsters, freaky things, the bosses, all kinds of crazy crap. Fire, campfires attacking you, you know, vultures, creepy looking trees, backgrounds, the music is kind of Halloween-y, you know, it all fits, I don't know. And number one would probably have to be one that most people probably wouldn't say is Splatterhouse, not any in particular, because there's Splatterhouse 2, 3, you know, there's a lot of them, just Splatterhouse in general, hell, even the very shyly made remake could count, I guess. I really mean the good old ones, but whatever. I don't know what else to say about it. It's just very gory, and the visuals are very, like, kind of like a thriller movie, almost, or a horror movie. It just fits. A couple of runners-up, which most people wouldn't know unless they played this type of stuff. There's some FMV games. Ripper is a good one. The Black Dahlia, that's a very good one. It's probably one of the few ones that would have, it's close to getting banned. Phantasmagoria and Phantasmagoria 2. Here's one that's not a FMV game, Clive Barker's Jericho. Trying to think what else there is. It's about all I have. But still, yeah, there's a couple runners up. So the real three would be, now I can't remember the order I did them in. I haven't been up long. Resident Evil, Ghouls and Ghosts, and Splatterhouse. No, actually, that is the order I did them in. Okay. So, yeah. Sorry about that. So, thanks for watching. I will see you next time. As always, I'm going to have a link down to the respective things in the description. And I will see you next time.